Welcome back to our April Stress Awareness Month series, part 2, Pathway to Peace, Embracing New Approaches to Stress Awareness. And in this part 2, we are going further with step 3, 4, and 5, which is about cultivating gratitude, incorporating movement, and seeking support if need be. Please enjoy, please like, comment, and subscribe if this is the type of content that adds value into your world, your life, and it's a learning and educational experience that you would like to see again. Thanks, A. Step 3, cultivate gratitude. Practice gratitude as a daily habit to shift your focus away from stresses and towards the positive aspects of your life. Take a few moments each day to reflect on the things you're grateful for. Whatever it is. Can be a supportive friend, a beautiful sunset, a small victory at work. Keeping a gratitude journal can be a powerful tool for cultivating gratitude and increasing resilience in the face of challenges. Embrace movement. Now, you know, we really want to avoid exercising, working out as much as we like, but we can't. We were made to move around. We've got legs, if you're lucky. So we can't avoid not working out, however you do it, right? However you do it. So let's just dive into this, because I know this is a difficult topic for most people. For me as well, I would start working out, then I would have a relapse, then I would start again, then I have a relapse. So I continuously in a battle with working out, but I don't give up. I don't give up. Incorporate movement into your daily routine to release tension and boost your mood. We all know, you know, exercises, there is something that happens there and it boosts your mood. You know that. Find activities that you enjoy, whether it's going for a walk, practicing yoga, or dancing to your favorite music. Movement not only helps to reduce stress, levels, but also promotes physical health and overall well-being. Aim to incorporate movement into your day in whatever way feels best for you. There's no rules there. Just do what works for you. And that's it. Now, this one is very important, especially in South Africa. Getting counseling, this type of things is not something that we feel that is only for the high net people, wealthy people. We don't feel it's for us. We can't afford it, that type of thing. But there are ways that you can really look at it different. And it is, if your stress levels is over the top to the point where you can't control it, it is taking you over your mental well-being, your physical well-being, seek support. Get support, right? And don't overanalyze that. Like, oh, what will somebody think if I ask them for help? I need someone to talk to. Oh, if I say to someone, they think I can't handle my problems. No, don't overanalyze it, right? You'll be surprised how many people can't deal with their daily problems. I mean, it's hectic. It's hectic. Everyone's problems for themselves is hectic. There's a saying, Every house carries its own cross. But sometimes you need someone to help you carry the cross. Right? Yeah, it's hectic. So let's just go with it. Don't be afraid to reach out for support when you need it. Whether it's talking to a trusted friend, seeking guidance from a mentor if you're lucky, or consulting with a professional therapist, right? Seeking support is a sign of strength, not a weakness, people. Surround yourself with a support network, a support structure of people who uplift and encourage you. You've seen these posts so many times on social media, where there is all sorts of quotes like get rid of negative energy, etc., etc. It's real, people. It is real. Imagine if you're with someone that's gonna nag and complain every single day around you. It's going to latch onto you. Now you have your own problems plus this person's negative energy. It is just something there, right? Anyway, let's continue. Don't hesitate to learn to lean. Sorry. Don't hesitate to lean on them during challenging times. If you're asking someone for support, if you have a support structure, if there's someone at home that you need to talk to, you know, stop the clock and say, can we just talk for 5 minutes? I don't feel like I can handle this. You'll be surprised how open people are to helping you. All right? Remember, you don't have to navigate stress alone. You don't have to deal with stress alone. You don't have to navigate stress alone. If you're sitting at your desk and it's just overwhelming, just say, and the manager comes over, and this is a very common thing. There's now a big hype around how big stress is at work. Like stress, literally 70% of stress is work stress, people. It's a dangerous environment. It can affect you if you don't know how to deal with it. If a manager comes with the wrong energy towards you, stop that manager. Say, please give me a moment. I just feel that you are at the moment upsetting me. If it's a good leader, they will walk away and realize what they're doing is not right. If it is someone that is abusive of nature, they're gonna overwhelm you. Why? How do you dare you say that? Don't take attention to it. You did the right thing. Stop that manager. Stop that supervisor. Stop that colleague. Stop that sister, the brother, the friend, the neighbor, the stranger. Stop them and say, excuse me, you are overwhelming me and you're causing stress at the moment towards me. Just give me a moment and I'll get back to you. You will be surprised. First of all, they're going to try it twice, but you keep to this routine and they will realize, this person is working on themselves and it is putting focus on us and on my bad behavior. They will realize it. Normally, it takes 3 times, right? It takes 21 days to get rid of a bad habit or an addiction. It takes 3 days to build a new habit. 3 days to build a new habit. Just 3 days. Okay? Stop the person or whatever is stressing you. Remember, earlier we said, not my circus, not my monkeys. These are all life hacks that helps with de-stressing. It costs nothing. It's just a practice that you need to put it into practice into your own life, incorporate it into your own life. You don't have to say it loud. Say it when someone comes to you and blah, 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 blah. Just quickly flip, pause your mind and say to yourself, not my monkeys, not my circus. Mentally, in your thoughts, you speak to yourself. The person is gonna, he's not reacting, she's not reacting. right? If you continue to stop the person and say, just please stop, you are overwhelming me, you're stressing me out, or I can feel what you are doing at the moment is not good for my mental health. You're going to see how shocked they're going to be. But you need to practice it. The coward will be stressed out. The coward is going to complain. Someone comes to you complaining every single day. Stop the person and say, you know what? I really care about you. I really have a great concern about you, seeing that nothing is going your way. But I notice that your negative attitude is latching onto me. Can I ask you to please stop nagging when you come close to me? Or if you don't have the guts to do that, when the person comes to you to nag, make an excuse and say, I quickly need to go to the toilet. They're going to start realizing you're ghosting them, right? And there's nothing wrong with it. It's just not positive energy that you need, and it's not helping you with de-stressing. That is just something I needed to say. Now that we have these 5 steps that you need to incorporate into your life, your choice, this is what I wanted to say. If you follow this pathway to alleviate stress in your life, you can cultivate a greater resilience, inner peace, and well-being in your life. I want to encourage you to embrace these new and fresh approaches to stress awareness and empower yourself to become a more balanced and better and healthier you. What do you have to lose? This post that I've just posted or going to post or am posting is free. There's no price tag on it. It's free. All you have to do is like, comment, subscribe. Okay? And I'm sure you're going to have a hard time liking as well. Or commenting as well. But the purpose of this is for you to become a more less stressor you. That's the purpose. If this helped you, if you like this type of content, please like, please comment, please subscribe. It helps me bring out more content that you like. I can only put out there if I know what you like. If I don't know what you like, I can't put it out there. Right? But I will use my discretion. Disclaimer, I will use my discretion. Thank you so much for your support. Till next time. See you.